Dylan, now, what do we mean when we say the 1, the 4, and 5? Can you give us a quick, let's introduce that. Why am I talking about numbers?
Why are numbers involved? I was told there would be no math. I was told. Okay, so basically, as you know, chords have letter names, right? And if they're assigned numbers, and traditionally Roman numerals, but those are complicated. That's why I never know what super bullet is. So if A is 1, B would be 2, C would be 3, D, and so on, right? So when I say 1 chord, it's applicable to any key. So now if we shift over, if we shift everything over to the key of C, for instance, C becomes 1, D is 2.
You start going up the alphabet, right?
Right. And so the number system gives us a way to have a universality between keys, right? Perfect. And that's the basic concept behind it.
So in this case, a lot of these songs we're hearing today and that we're playing today, that we're in the key of E, so that's our 1 chord.
Right.
And if we go up the E scale, when we go 1, 2, 3, 4, we have A. So we play
that's
our
right.
A chord, and that's our 4 chord. And then when we go up to 5, that's our B chord. And then usually that resolves back to the 1 chord of E. This reminds me of an anecdote that Paul McCartney has told many years now. When he and John and George were young guys in Liverpool, they knew A, they knew D, and they knew E. And they could learn quite a few songs, quite a few tunes back then. But they heard about a guy that knew B7. Now, they'd heard the term B7, and they knew that that was the lost chord. That was the missing chord. So they took a bus. They transferred several times to get all the way across town and, you know, knocked on the guy's door. And said, are you the guy that knows B7? He said, yes, I am. And, yeah. And so we'll show it to us, you know. And he said, okay. So
B7 caller.
Got it, buddy. Yeah, exactly. He got on the bus, went back across town and showed everybody. Because that really unlocked a lot of tunes. They really listened to lost songs in E, and there was a third chord that they couldn't play. You know, it's a really it's a game changer at that point. So everybody, if you learn E, A, and B, these three chords, you have you're pretty empowered. You have a real proper cadence that covers a lot of different tunes. So because 1-4-5 is such a big part of modern music, and it allows us to use these chords in tons of styles and genres. Let's hear some of this in action with some tunes that you can learn on Fender Play. So obviously all the songs we're doing today are on the site. And we're going to start, you can do a beautiful country ballad a la Willie Nelson in the key of E. You can do Blue Eyes Crying in the Rain.
In the twilight glow I see
cadence for you there, Dylan.
Right? That was, you
three
know,
chords.
That was fantastic, Eugene.
Oh, well, so credit good. To Willie Nelson. He teaches everything, but just a great, great ballad that you can tell a great, great story and cause a lot of emotion just with three chords. You can also sing one of the earliest social protest songs in the history of rock and roll, Summertime Blues.
Well, I'm gonna raise a fuss, I'm gonna raise a holler. Working all summer just to try to earn a dollar. And when I call a baby and try to get a date, the boss says, no die, son, you gotta work late. Sometimes I wonder what I'm gonna do, but there ain't no cure for the summertime blues.
You just watched a preview of Fender Play's Mastering the G, C, and D Chords collection. Click the link to learn more about guitar chords, then put your skills to use by learning to play the songs you love. The Fender Play app offers a completely customizable learning experience for anyone who wants to learn to play guitar, bass, or ukulele. And you can track your progress while you learn to play using over 3,000 lessons and innovative practice features like our chord challenge, backing tracks, and weekly gear giveaways. Click the link to sign up for your free trial of Fender Play today. No credit card required.